That he was the one who made all this,
and that he was the greatest king of all.
just as that baby was held by his mother.
He would hold me with his amazing grace.
And his adoption by his father Joseph would be a picture of my adoption into his family.
Who could comprehend that this baby was, who was defenseless, swaddled in hell, would someday be the one holding me in his hands?
I didn't witness a star moving across the sky, the scores of angels proclaiming his birth. But somehow, in the middle of my ordinary world,
this extraordinary baby's birth found a place in my warm, down in the barn.
So like all those people who saw this, he's the one I've been waiting for.
To repair me.
Redeem me.
Love me.
Forgive me.
Comfort me.
Help me.
Raise me to life.
What child is this? He's the one who comes to save me.
To save me.
He's the one who comes to save me.
Yeah. bit. Well, praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord!
I'm going to read something to you. You don't have to follow along with me. It's going to be out of the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 6 and 7. I'm going to tell you, as I read this, I want you all to know that my heart is full. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. My heart is full here this morning, brother. I'm already, my cup's already overflowing.
Amen.
You know, it doesn't matter. A man can stand on the corner street and scream watermelon, but if the Holy Ghost is with him and inspiring it, then praise God, it'll change lives. Amen.
Amen.
And it doesn't matter. These little kids come up here, they do the best they can. You know, you see the excitement. I like to see some of that excitement in them and some of you when you're praising God. You know, we get together a lot of times with people. You'll say, ask people to say praise the Lord. They're kind of, they give God a tease. They're like, well, praise God. I'm just glad I made it here today. Now, these kids get excited about God. Amen. And that's how we should be, because we're here to celebrate the greatest gift that was ever given to mankind. Bar none, there is nothing better than Jesus. There's no other problem. There's no other solution to any problem. Amen. You give me Jesus, and I'll tell you, it's the answer to whatever ails you here today. Amen. Let me tell you something. Jesus Christ can fix what religion will leave broken. I'm just going to preach for a minute. Jesus Christ will fix what religion will leave sick, dead, dying, and twisted. Jesus Christ will answer the questions that man ponders and says cannot be answered. Amen. Jesus Christ will answer those sleepless nights. He'll answer those sick bodies. He'll answer those perplexed minds. Jesus Christ is your deliverance from any type of addiction that you might have today. Jesus Christ is the answer for the dependence you have on things that are ungodly. Jesus Christ is the answer. Amen. Let me tell you something. You can go find religion. There's religion on every corner in this town. You can find religion here. You can find religion there. You can find religion everywhere. But religion will never set you free. Amen. Observing a certain day will never set you free. Observing a certain night will never set you free. But you get a hold of the Master. You get a hold of the Lord. And the day, you know, Jesus Christ, he couldn't even go to a funeral, brother, without messing it up. Because the dead would come right up out of their graves. Amen. He couldn't even. Let me read this. They say you're crazy, brother. Yeah, you better believe it. I'm crazy. Let me tell you something. If anyone in here today was to come up here and stick your finger in a 110 outlet, you jump around a little bit. Amen. Well, let me tell you something. I'm hooked into something a lot more powerful than that. And it causes me to jump and scream and get a little crazy. Because you know what? I had religion for so long.
Come on.
I'll just share this with you. I've been dead, dried up, sitting on the prune. Sitting like an old dried up prune on the field. Amen. Some people talk about, well, we're just laid back Christians. No, you're laid back religious. You're laid back. People say, well, that ain't good to do in church, really. Well, I guess heaven's wrong. And my Bible says that around the throne of God, every day, there's choirs of angels, choirs of saints, choirs of stuff we can't even imagine. That is singing and praising God at the top. Let me tell you, if you don't like loud church, you ain't going to like loud heaven. Amen. There ain't a quiet section of there. The Bible says that they continuously sat around the throne of the King, screaming, holy, 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 thou God Almighty, who is and was and is to come. Amen.
Amen.
It ain't quiet up there. We shouldn't be quiet. See, that's the problem is we've been at church, we've been silent too long. We've got this gift. We've got the greatest gift that man's ever known. And we go around all the time acting like it's something we should be hid or ashamed of. Oh, you shouldn't bring up that religiousness here today. Oh, you shouldn't bring that up. Oh, let me tell you something. Everywhere I am, people are going to know I know who Jesus is.
Amen.
I may be in the middle, but let me tell you something. I might be in a dark spot somewhere in my life, and I don't want him to deny me. So I'm not going to deny him. I might be sitting in a truck stop in the middle of Arizona, and people around here are going to know who Jesus Christ is. Amen. I don't mean I'm going to run up screaming at him, but I hope my life, praise God, lays it out who I believe in. Amen. Okay, so we don't always get everything right. We don't always get everything down to exactly the way it should be, but that's all right because the Bible says that I've got an advocate. Bible says, if I'll call out, brother and sister, that there's an advocate waiting on the other side for me, amen? There's a priest who perpetually makes atonement for my sins. Do you know what that means? That means that when I say, Lord, forgive me, the sacrifice is
done.
See, that gets people into trouble because it's too easy. See, religion don't like that. Religion wants you to go jump through some hoops. Religion wants you to go over here and do some other things. Religion wants you to get down on your knees and say 20 Hail Marys. They want you to confess your sins to a priest. They want you to give up pork or give up meat or give up this or give up that. Why? Well, it's all because of an innermost desire that mankind has to make God a debtor to him. And the Lord Bible says that God will be a debtor to no man. The only way you're ever going to get to heaven is down in heaven. And you look around this room. None of us will make it unless we go through the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. And if we get to add anything on to that Bible, if we add anything whatsoever on to that or take it away, the Bible says in the book of Revelation, we need to take away our flesh. I'm going to tell you something enough about that. I'm going to tell you what we got to look forward to. Amen.
Amen.
We have a dinner every year. You know, they're Christians today battling it out over Christmas. As Christians today, right now, attacking each other about whether they should celebrate Christmas. Let me tell you something. It's a day. The Bible says, if I got Jesus, I should celebrate with him. The Bible also says, see, I'm just going to refer back to the Bible. I ain't going to argue with you. I ain't going to debate. I'm just going to refer to the Bible. Like that, I don't get in trouble that way. The Bible says, if I say I have a day that I celebrate, book of Colossians, sister, if I have a day I'm going to call holy to the Lord and I celebrate it, then I'm blessed in that. Amen. Which means if I want to make up a whole new holiday,
amen,
as long as I'm celebrating Jesus, I can do it.
Amen.
Amen. If I want to start having church on Tuesday, I'll be just as bright as somebody having it on Sunday.
Amen.
Amen. Because of this, Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 says, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, and to establish it with judgment and with justice. From henceforth, even forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Everything that we know of, church, that Jesus Christ has done was ordained from the beginning of time that he would perform those things. Everything that we know of, since the time he came and said and taught and walked with me, and everything that he promised that he would do on his return, has already been marked down in the history of heaven as being something that he will perform. And I want to leave you all with a few thoughts. Church, Jesus Christ came to die for the white man, the brown man, the black man, the red man, the yellow man, all men. The truth of the matter is we all believe the same. Jesus Christ will return and he'll reestablish his throne in Israel. And the Jewish people will be the leaders of the world the way they were always intended to be. He will sit upon the throne of David. And I agree or disagree, but let me tell you something, church. The Catholics believe that somehow we replaced the Jews. I don't buy that. Because my Bible right here, I just said that he would sit on the throne of David. And you know something? That takes me back. God promised David.
Give me my nose back.
God's not done with the Jewish people. You know, this past
week. Let me get you will.
And I'm not one of these people that's going to stand here and say, well, on this day, the world's ended. Don't believe in that.
Amen.
Been whole cults and cultures started on people trying to predict dates. Amen. And I want to tell you this. We're moving inch closer. Right now, for the first time in modern history, Jerusalem is recognized as the capital of Israel. And I thank God. I'm not going to thank Donald Trump for that because God moved on that in his time. But I thank God that God had people in place that he could use his instruments to make that happen. And I thank God because that's very important to us as Christians. Not just to the Jewish people, but to us. Because everything, that's just another piece of prophecy being fulfilled, church. You see, it's going to end up that Jerusalem will be the capital of the whole world before this is all said and done. Just like it was ordained to be for the beginning. And I all we have to do now, we're another step for another reason to look for a church. I was sitting here thinking, one of the lines that I think Tristan read, or one of the boys said, I didn't see the stars. But I'm going to tell y'all what I did see. See, I didn't make a trail from the east to Bethlehem. I wasn't alive then. I didn't go by the manger and see him laying there. I wasn't one of the shepherds in the field that saw the angels proclaiming the birth of the Messiah into the world. But I tell you what I did see. It was one day in the year 2004 that I saw heaven with my own eyes. And it was in the form of a God that I had known and denied. See, I didn't need to see a star in the sky, because that star, the one that created that star, fluttered into my heart. And he began to break some bondages that were in me. And he began to break some things that were in me. And he began to set me free. And see, he began to do something religion could never do. Look, you can go and you can practice whatever you want. Religion will never bring you the peace of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that's the reason for the season.
Amen.
That's the reason why we're here. So whether we've got the right day or not, I don't care. I don't care if Jesus was born in spring, summer, winter, or fall. I just know he was born.
Amen.
He was born so that I could be born again. And that same offer stands for you. So I'm gonna offer you this. And then we're gonna do something else before we dismiss, but I'm gonna offer you this. While the brother gets something ready here, if I could get everybody that can and will to stand with me for just one quick moment. And I would like for all eyes to be closed and all heads bowed and no one moving around. And I'd love to ask you, do you know when? Now listen, just knowing the name of Jesus ain't enough. And to be honest with you, just going to church ain't enough. To be real factual accurate with you today, I want to ask you, do you know him? Is he in your heart? Or do you have a religion? You know, the Bible says that you say you believe in the Lord. It says, it goes on to say you do well, but also understand that the devils even believe and tremble in the Lord. So just believing in who he was, and do you know him? The Lord came to have a relationship with you. He came to minister directly onto you. He came to save you. He wants to be your God. In other words, he doesn't want you to have to get up and go somewhere and hear what God... He wants you to be able to talk to him. He wants you, when you open your eyes, to commune with him. And folks, you don't get through there through all the hoops and all kinds, man. I could stand here and listen and hear that all day, neither do I. Man has made so many rules and regulations to get to God that it's unbelievable. And Christ only ever asked for one. He said, believe in me. Believe in me. You're born again. You're born of the Spirit. You see, now that's the important part too. We've got to be born again. He told Nicodemus asked him, he said, well, how can I go back into my mother's womb? He said, you don't understand, Nicodemus. I'm not talking about being the physical birth. I'm talking about you being born once of flesh and blood, and then again of the Spirit. So I'm going to ask you this. I'm just going to say for yourself. Are you born again? I'm not going to ask you if you know Jesus. Everybody here should know who Jesus is. Are you born again? You got yourself a religious relationship, and you've got a born-again relationship, and you know there's a difference. And right now, if the Holy Spirit's knocking on that heart, it's a better time, because you know this is the last service we'll have all together before Christmas comes. I want to know, are you going to be able to celebrate? I mean, really celebrate. I can remember my first Christmas after being born again, and And I remember feeling a peace and a celebration I never felt in my Christmas ever. So as the brother plays this, I'm just going to ask you real quick, do you know him? Are you ready, brother?